The Philippines will reject onion imports arriving beyond the government's January 27 deadline. That assurance coming from the Plant Industry Bureau as the first batch of imported onions arrive in the country. The agency says it will strictly implement the timeline to avoid flooding the market with supply.
Nasa may 218 metric tons po ng dilaw na sibuyas o yung puting sibuyas. 370 po metric tons ng pulang sibuyas yung nasa cold storage na po, at kasalukuyan po siyang nakasalang sa second border inspection. So yung proseso po na ito, ini-inspect po natin yung dumating po na containers at sinisiguro po natin na ang nilalaman po na yun ay kung ano po yung idineklara. Inaasahan po natin na within this week po, maaari na po nating mabili yung mga sibuyas na pumasok dito.
The Agriculture Department, headed by no less than President Marcos himself, earlier allowed the importation of over 21,000 metric tons of onions into the country in a bid to tame the rising prices of the commodity.
Maynilad customers can expect a rebate after the Metropolitan Waterworks and Sewerage System, or MWSS, slaps a hefty fine on the concessionaire. Alvin Lechico tells us why.
The MWSS Regulatory Office has imposed a penalty of more than 27 million pesos against Maynilad for the water service interruptions during the holiday season. This means there will be a rebate for customers affected, particularly those living in southern Metro Manila and Cavite. But the regulator is still finalizing how many customers are going to get a rebate and the amount each customer will get.
For example, if a customer usually pays around 200 pesos and then the rebate is around 300 pesos, let's say, diba? For example, meron siya magiging negative balance of 100 pesos. So something similar to that. Our determination is solely ito.
The family of Diday Sanje is just one of the thousands of customers of Maynilad who experienced prolonged water service interruption last November and December.
Kung ibabalik nila yung magandang rebate, eh, okay lang. Kahit pa, sige na lang. Kasi wala naman nga po kaming magagawa eh. Ibigay nyo yung dapat na rebates para sa mga consumer na katulad ko.
Kasi o ibalik,
ang servisyo na maganda naman na katulad noon.
For eatery owner Thelma, the rebate is small if it only amounts to 200 to 300 pesos.
Sa ilang oras po eh, nawalan tubig eh. Hindi, sulit.
Oh, ano ba yung sulit?
Mga isang buwan, walang bayad. Mahigit 1,000 po.
This is already the fifth penalty imposed against Maynilad since 2019. The regulator warns Maynilad to fix its service if it wants to get the second and succeeding tranches of rate increases.
They have service obligations that they have to meet. They have targets that they have to meet, that they have committed for this year. So pag hindi nila nagawa yun, we won't be giving them their additional increase by next year.
The MWSS Regulatory Office has also alerted residents of Metro Manila and neighboring provinces of a projected shortage in water supply in the near future.
Kung ang projection lang natin na babasihan is the population, most likely next year magkaroon talaga ng problema. But kung may mag-deliver na new water source, na bagong supply for Metro Manila, Cavite and Rizal, that will address the issue.
As the Caliwa Dam project remains hanging, Maynilad has started the construction of a new water treatment plant in Muntinlupa, which can process raw water from Laguna Lake and can produce an additional 150 million liters per day starting mid-2024. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
The New Year's Day travel chaos at Philippine airports was caused by an electromechanical malfunction. That's according to Information and Communications Technology Secretary Ivan John Puy. He adds the incident does not indicate a cyber attack. Now, weeks ago, aviation officials took full accountability for the crisis that paralyzed the entire country's air traffic.
It was basically an electromechanical malfunction that triggered the whole incident. But nonetheless, we took the opportunity to conduct a thorough review and cybersecurity audit of the whole system, since we're already there, in order to ensure that the system is adequately protected from any cybersecurity threats.